Hello everyone, I'm Rashi Goyal and I'm pursuing BLLB from University of Petroleum in Energy Studies, Dehradun. And currently, I'm a legal intern at Lexis & Company for the month of June. So in today's video, I'll be discussing about citizenship under the Citizenship Act. Parliament, in the exercise of the powers given to it under Article 11 of the Indian Constitution, has passed the Citizenship Act 1955, making provisions for acquiring and termination of citizenship after the commencement of the Constitution. The Act provides for the acquisition of Indian citizenship after the commencement of Indian Constitution in 5 different ways: by birth, by descent, by registration, by naturalization, and by incorporation of territory. So, first mode is by birth. A person can acquire citizenship by birth under certain conditions. If he or she is born in India, or either or both or either of his parents are born in India, and neither of them are illegal immigrants of India. A person born in India on or after 26 January 1950 is a citizen of India by birth, except when his or her parents have diplomatic immunity or not citizen of India, or his or her parents are an enemy alien, or the birth occurs at the place under the occupation of such enemy. Now, second way is by descent. A person born outside India can be a citizen of India by descent. A person born outside the India after 26 January 1951 is a citizen of India by descent if at the time of his birth his father is an Indian citizen. But when his birth is registered at an Indian consulate, or his father is at the time of his birth on service under the Indian government. Similarly, any person born outside the territory of undivided India who was or deemed to be an Indian citizen at the commencement of the Indian Constitution is also considered to be a citizen of India by descent only. So, third way is by registration. A person who wants to acquire citizenship by registration must fulfill any of the certain conditions. First is a person of Indian origin or parents who were born in undivided India and who are ordinarily resident in India for 7 years. Second, a person of Indian origin who is ordinarily resident in any other country or place outside undivided India. Third, a person who are or have been married to Indian citizen and who are ordinary resident in India for 5 years. Fourth, minor children, both whose parents are Indian citizens. And fifth, a citizen of Singapore and Canada who is resident in India for 5 years and 8 years respectively. Now, let's talk about the fourth way, that is by naturalization. Citizenship of India can be acquired by a foreigner who is ordinarily resident in India for a period of 12 years continuously for 12 months preceding the date of application and for 11 years in the aggregate in the 14 years preceding the 12 months. And the last, that is fifth way, is by incorporation of territory. If any new territory becomes part of India, the government of India shall specify the persons of that territory to be the citizen of India. Now, next, let's discuss about the termination of citizenship under the Citizenship Act. The citizenship of a person can be terminated by 3 modes. So, first mode is by renunciation of citizenship. A person of full age and capacity in a prescribed manner can renounce the citizenship of India. But such application will be withheld during the time of emergency or war. If a married couple renounces their citizenship, their child also ceases to be an Indian citizen unless 1 year after attaining the majority, the child applies via registration for citizenship, shall continue to be the citizen of India. Second, by operation of law. If a person gets the citizenship of another country, then Indian citizenship ceases to exist, as multiple or dual citizenship is not permitted in India. And third is by deprivation. If a person has acquired the citizenship of India by fraudulent means, then the government of India has the power to deprive the person of his citizenship. And lastly, we'll talk about the overseas citizenship of India. If a person has migrated from India to other countries, then he can or he is said to be OCI, that is overseas citizenship of India, unless the country permits OCI citizenship. Overseas citizenship can't be considered dual citizenship, as the person won't get certain privileges. First, they don't have right to vote. Second, they cannot hold an Indian passport. Third, they are not eligible for constitutional post. And fourth, they cannot be the member of legislature of any house. Thus, a person who wants to acquire citizenship of India can make use of provisions either under the Constitution of India or the Citizenship Act. Thank you everyone for watching my video. I hope you like it, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends and family. And don't forget to let me know your feedback in the comment section. Stay home, stay safe, stay healthy.